Hi, my name is Keith Wood. I'm a community forester with the Colorado State Forest Service. We would like everybody to know about a serious threat to our urban forests in Colorado called the emerald ash borer, or EAB for short. EAB was found in Boulder, Colorado in the fall of 2013. Prior to that, it was initially found in the United States in the Detroit, Michigan area in 2002. Only true ash trees in the genus Fraxinus are at risk from this pest. So this is a serious threat we need to be aware of. One of the first things that we'd like you to be aware of is if you have an ash tree or not. And we're going to show you how to identify those properly today. Ash trees come in many shapes and sizes. For the most part, they mature into large shade trees. We have various species of ash trees in Colorado to be aware of. There are some common varieties that are also planted in many of our landscapes. This includes varieties of the green ash species like Patmore green ash, Summit green ash, and a tried and true cultivated variety called Marshall seedless. There are also cultivated varieties from the white ash species. I'm standing by one here now that's called Autumn Purple. The Autumn Purple ash is a very commonly planted white ash tree in the state of Colorado in our communities. And it can turn a very vibrant shade of purple to burgundy in the fall. So it's very noticeable in the fall. Whereas the green ash trees will turn a more golden yellow. To identify if you have an ash tree, look for these following traits. One of the first things to look for is the opposite branching structure that we find on ash trees. Ash trees have opposite branching, meaning the branches, as they develop, will come out opposite each other. Whereas other species have alternate branching, where the branches will come out alternating along the stem as it develops and grows. There are only a couple of tree species that we'll find with opposite branching in our landscapes, the ash and the maple. The ash have a compound leaf, generally with 5 to 9 leaflets per leaf, whereas the maple is a simple leaf. So it's easy to determine an ash tree from a maple when the leaves are on the trees. The other thing to look for is a pattern in the bark. On mature ash trees, we're going to find a diamond-shaped pattern that develops on both white and green ash trees here, whereas on maple trees, we won't see that pattern in the bark. Another thing to look at, and this is when we're distinguishing species within the ash group, we'll have white ash trees with a more broad leaflet. They will have basically an entire or smooth margin or coarsely toothed margin, whereas the green ash leaflets will be a little smaller and have a more serrated or toothed margin. Now that you've determined if you have an ash tree, it's time to make a decision on what you'd like to do with that ash tree going forward. For more information on how to identify ash trees and how to manage them moving forward, please go to our website, the Colorado State Forest Service website, or eabcolorado.com